grandmother told my mother it's Africa at work. My grandmother told my mother it's Africa at work. My grandmother told my mother it's Africa at work. My grandmother told my mother it's Africa at work.
What's going on, y'all? That was just Jay-Z with Dead Presidents. What album we had that from, man? We got that in 96 on Reasonable Doubt.
Yep.
Great album, man. Before that, we had the Notorious B.I.G. with The Sky's the Limit.
Word.
For that, we had Tupac with So Many Tears. Wu-Tang Clan with Cream. Nas, Made You Look. J Dilla with Feel This. Can't say that word because we might get in trouble. And we will get in trouble. No swears, man. No swears out here, man.
Try not to.
Mobb Deep with Survival of the Fittest. Lost Ones from Lauryn Hill. J Dilla with... We had Common with The Light, actually. That was a mistake on my end. It's a little dark in here, so your boy can't see the best. We had The Roots with...
We got to chill.
Do you want more?
Oh, do you want more? Come on. Damn, shoot.
Come on, Cody. All right, I'm about to bash Cody's hand running for a second. Then we had EPMD with You Guys to Chill. Then we had Public Enemy with Fight the Power. Today we have a special show on our hands, y'all. We got the legend, the myth, the man, the legend in here, man. We got Myron Moye, you know.
A.k.a. Krush Money.
Krush Money.
Okay.
Come on, come on the mic. Can hear you, man.
Devastating Krush
Come
money.
On over here, man. Come on
money.
Over here, brother.
Yeah.
So,
Yeah, what's good, y'all? You know, it's your boy, the Hopper legend. You know what I'm saying? Rest in peace, Cut Master Bistro, the originator. Busy Boys for Life. You know how we do. Yeah.
Questions? Yeah, man. So, I just want to say it's a pleasure having you on the show, man. You know,
Thank you, brother.
On our last show, we had Professor Marco on here. He was giving us a background on the Hartford Hip Hop Pioneers Project. And I was discussing how me and John actually chose you.
Yeah.
So when I found out he could rap, I'm like, man, you know what? Why not tie in him rapping? You know, he's a legend, you know what I mean? So why not get him on the show, man? By the way, you guys are listening to Africa at Work with the Trinity Chapter of Temple of Hip Hop with DJ Trouble Kid.
Yes, sir.
And your boy, Cody David.
Yes, sir.
You know what I'm saying? Make some noise for that one time, man. But we're going to dive into this interview, man.
Let's go.
So, give us a rundown on how many years you've been at this, Myron, because you've been at this for a while, man. You've been at this longer than my existence,
1983, man. I started this shit in 1983. Oops, excuse me.
Oh,
I'm hood, y'all. I don't want to get these brothers in trouble. That's my bad. Put it on my resume.
I'm weak. Can you give us a rundown of some of the first songs that you ever created?
Well, the first song that I created, actually, I got it in my pocket in there. The first song I ever done, but I brought it just in case you want to run it. But I've been doing it since 1983. I had an album out in 1986 when I got put on B-Boy Records. I'm just going through this real quickly. I was up on B-Boy Records from 1986 to 88. And I did some traveling and lots of shows, of course. Me and my DJ, Cutmaster Bistro. He was the hottest DJ on the planet, actually in the universe.
Universe.
Yeah, the universe, I give him that. And, you know, we just lost him. In 2015, you know, he was firefighter Kevin Bell. Everybody know they heard that name. Can you hear me?
Yeah.
Okay. You know what I'm saying? So I'm still holding it down from home. So we just finished the album just before he passed away. We just finished a 22-song album. And, you know, it's about to be released now. You know, I had to wait not too long, you know, a couple of years because I had to get my mind right because I didn't feel like rapping no more. You know, I started out this stuff with him. And then I had to carry it on without him, and I didn't want to do it. But, you know, people were telling me, yo, man, this album is hot. You need to just go ahead and do the thing, man. So here we go. We about to drop next month. You know what I'm saying? The whole album. And, you know, we got a hot video coming. It's already complete. It's all CGI, special effects. It's graphics. It's like $100,000 look, you know what I'm saying? You know, we doing it big. I got to do it big for my man, you know what I'm saying? Because my man was lavish with things, man, so I got to keep it like that, you know?
Yeah, I actually was, I was scrolling through YouTube as a part of the project, and I actually came across a video of Bistro, and I was just kind of blown away because I'm like, This man was nice,
man.
You know what I mean? One DJ to another, man. I wish I could get down on the 1200s like he did.
Ooh, that boy.
He was cold, man. Look, I'm not gonna sugarcoat anything, y'all. I'm on the controller at the moment. You know, I got to get my levels up to Bistro, man. Rest in peace to that legend, man.
Definitely.
So what's the name of this project?
Well, we named it Life After B-Boy because you know we were on B-Boy Records back in the days. We were a label mates with KRS-One, Scott LaRock, the Cold Krush Brothers. It was a long list, man. The JBC Force. It was a host, man. It was just a long list of us, man. But we just named it after the fact that we was on B-Boy Records. Plus, we look at hip-hop now. The B-Boy culture has changed. You know, brothers are wearing dresses now.
No names.
I ain't gonna say no names, but everybody saw that Florida Evans dress on that guy. So I don't have to elaborate any further. But you know, the hip hop is like it has changed and turned into something else. So it's life after B-Boy, because B-Boy is dead. You feel me? That was Kangos and the fat shoelaces and, you know, the B-Boy stance. That was B-Boy. Now I don't know what this is right now, man. If you ain't got on a dress or a halter top, you ain't popping. And like I told you in the other interview, I don't got the legs for it, so I'm always out with some baggy pants. You ain't gonna catch me in no dress. Let's get it.
So can you tell me a little bit more about your growing up, you know, being signed to B-Boy Records? What was that like? How was it like
Being on B-Boy Records was really back then, because we coming from Hartford, Connecticut, where there was nothing going on here. You know what I'm saying? Nobody was actually, back then, nobody. We had a few people that could rap and stuff, but nobody wasn't really doing anything with it, but just local, get on the mic and little talent shows and stuff like that. Right. I saw further than that. I used to actually have stacks of records and read everything on the back, all of the information. No, I used to find out where the companies were. I was 16 years old. I'd get on the Greyhound bus, catch the taxi in New York, flag it down and go to these companies. You know what I'm saying? I'll go to Warner Brothers and I'll go to Island Records myself. And they was impressed with, like, this little guy come from where? Connecticut. I mean, I really didn't get nothing out of it back then, but really like a couple of stacks of records and a handshake and, oh man, you keep going, you're gonna get it. Until I lucked up with the B-Boy Records thing. So, you know.
Did you have any other contracts on the table with any other labels at the time?
Nah.
Or was it just B-Boy?
Nah, actually, that wasn't supposed to happen, you know what I'm saying?
Really?
Because New York, you know, back then, up until the end of New York held hip-hop to themselves. You know, they wasn't letting nobody in. And I snuck in. They didn't know where I was from, you know what I'm saying? Because I was up in New York so much, they didn't know. They thought I was from New York anyway, so I let them think what they wanted to think so I can get in. I slid in. But nah, man. Out here, it wasn't popping like that, and we was the first ones out of here with that. We got on a, you know, we had people around here making these little janky labels, you know what I'm saying? Man, we didn't get on nothing like that. I wouldn't get on that. I wouldn't get into contests. I was like, nah, I'm going to keep my status before I'm going to let anybody break me, you know what I'm saying? And
right.
So when we came out with the B-Boy Records thing, we was the first. Everybody was on us. We didn't have to come and beg the radio stations to play our music or none of that stuff. I could be walking down the street and I could hear my stuff playing out of people's, blaring out of people's windows, blaring out of people's cars. I mean, it was really a good thing back then. Hip hop has changed in another way out here. It's like the DJs out here they want to be Funk Master Flex. So, you know, the artists is getting no love. You feel me?
Word. Now, can you go in further into detail about Hartford during the 80s?
During the 80s?
80s and 90s, yeah, early 90s.
Well, I can tell you this. It was a fun time. Everything was, like, taking off from there. I mean, from Hartford, like, we're a town where we blow things up. You know what I'm saying? We don't have much. We have B-Market. Everybody comes here to make their money. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
Mobb Deep, you know, rest in peace, Prodigy. But them dudes, they didn't have a record for 3 or 4 years. They can come out here and do shows. And I mean, everybody come here and get that paper. You know what I'm saying? So this is a little B-Market, get that paper place, you know what I'm saying? That's all it really is here.
Okay. And I heard you mention that all the DJs are trying to be Funk Master Flex,
yeah.
So the artists don't get much love. Do you think radio play plays a huge role in the rise of a lot of MCs within their hometowns?
Yeah, definitely. You know, I mean, if you ain't, if you're not being heard, then what are you doing? You know what I'm saying? So, yeah. Oh yeah, okay. It's in the email, B. Yeah, yeah, you know what I'm saying? Y'all gotta excuse me, man. I'm working and at the same time I'm interviewing, you dig? So excuse the boy.
So I wanna get into this, yo.
Let's go.
I wanna see him spit a couple bars for me real quick.
Yeah, I'll spit something for y'all, man.
What do you wanna spit over? What are you trying to spit over?
Yo, I wanna spit to my boy Tupac, man. Hail Mary.
Hail Mary?
Give these cats some of that, you know what I'm saying?
All right.
You know, keep it traditional hip hoppy. Hop, hop, hop.
You gotta get the headphones.
Gotta get the headphones
on
for us.
Yeah, I definitely need those.
You know what I'm saying? Gotta put those on.
Gotta definitely do that. Yes, sir. I'm
gonna cook up this Hail Mary real quick.
Oh, man. Yo. Yo, peep this, y'all. Bistro recipes, baby. Hey, yo. I spit like fireworks, homo thug, try your skirt. One shot to the chest, got them dying hurt. Those the ones die alert, those the ones getting dressed up in a suit and tie and shirt, lie them down in dirt in a casket, 6 feet up under the earth. I hit him up for what he's worth. Yo, it's getting worse, I'm shooting up the hearse at the funeral, riding on the church, crowds dispersed. Perhaps his grandmother dying first, face down, lying by a purse. His brother made it to the hospital, but he's dying, lying by the nurse. I cock and squeeze, my iron fire bursts, and you hate it. It's best to believe I try and fire first. Rapper slash high roller, ride or die first. Only way you be the man if I retire first. So don't bother, try your verse. Your vocabulary's mad shallow, every couple lines, why you gotta curse? Rappers ain't worth a half a stack. If they clapping, then I'm clapping back. Mess around and get stabbed in your back. Perhaps you should've packed your gat. And if I just so happened to catch the rat, perhaps I'll put a slug up in his fitted cap. If it was 1973, I would've put a slug up in his Applejack. Bloody massacre like the last attack. Spit crack like it's a half a crack. Keep the K up in the Cadillac. What you laughing at? We jacking your team for your cream and you can't redeem it, ever have it back. Imagine that. Rappers that swagger jack get their tops pop like a freaking box of Cracker Jacks. I'm a gangster, you don't have to ask. You better ask. Rappers panicking, they can't relax. They know they messing with a real OG rapper that can't be matched. Facts. Let's get it. B-Boy Records, Busy Boys. Woo. Got Master B Stroke, Krush Money in the building. Harper, stand up. Let's get it.
Whoa. Yo, come on, man. You can't.
Yeah.
Come, yo.
Yeah.
You still doing it like?
I'm still doing it like
83,
that. 1983, baby.
83. It's 2017.
Check me in 3030. It's still going to happen.
He's coming. He's coming like that, man. Yo. What inspires you to keep going? Like, what really inspires you to keep this thing going, man, to keep this momentum?
It's in me, baby. It's in me. I can't get rid of it. I tried. I stopped for a year, 2 years. Pick up a pencil, and I'm still fire. It ain't going nowhere.
Yeah, I can't relate. I can't relate. I tried to pick up a pencil at a point in time in my life. And,
we all have, you know?
Yeah, and I ended up DJing, you know? That.
Well, you got something over me. You got something on me. Yeah. I can't DJ.
Like my mama always said, get in where you fit in. So that's great, man. And
thanks, brother.
So let's dive into something else, man. You mentioned B-boying.
Yeah.
So you actually got a history.
Yeah.
This guy has a history, not only with just hip-hop in terms of rapping and...
breakdancing.
But he actually was one of the first... You created one of the first break groups here, man.
Yeah.
So let's talk about that a little bit.
Let's get it.
So, explain... let's talk... All right, how do I say this? Explain what the Master Poppers were to Hartford.
Well, me and my brother Mike, we founded that group. You know what I'm saying? We put it together. It was just me and him. And we went out and sought a few other guys to get down. I got my boy Dooney, man. You know, the dude that owned the barbershop out there. I know y'all all know Dooney. His cousin BT. I know y'all all know Jazzy John. DJ Jazzy John used to be a DJ right here. He used to be up in here, cutting up in here. I got him. And, you know, we got into this little contest in 1983. Again, we got into a little contest that Tim Wolf, you know what I'm saying?
From the Peace Train.
Shout out to Tim Wolf. That's the man right there. He was the first funky white dude out here. And he was rapping before me. Tim Wolf.
Wait, Tim was rapping?
Tim was rapping DJing in 1983.
Tim
Wolf. And he looked just like John Lennon, ponytail, and he would get up on the microphone and rap, and people would have been amazed.
He did more than just play the sax.
He did more than just play the sax.
What we was told was that he just played the sax.
No, just the sax. This guy plays the deuce and goonie, all types of African instruments, and, yo, the guy is an eccentric guy, man. I mean, what can I say, man?
Tim, if you tuned in, brother, please send me some of your music. Please.
You have one. That Afro Jazz Hop.
Yeah.
Actually his single. And
I'm talking about his throwback music.
Oh, his throwback music.
Yeah. Okay. We need some of that, Tim. So if you're listening, brother, send it on over here, man.
We need to see those bars for
real. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So speaking of this Afro Jazz Hop. Explain this track before we play this, man. Explain what inspired this record.
Well, you know, Tim asked me, did I want to do something with him again? Because, you know, we ain't worked in 1,000 years, over 30. And when we finally got together, he said I'd still be burning shit. Oh, stop. Excuse me. Achoo.
He said ship, y'all.
Because I am the captain of the ship. But, you know, he asked me, you know, I want to do a track with him. And I said, sure, why not? Because he got all of this music that he does, and it's just music. It's that melodic. It's real, you know. And he was like, yo, just listen to this track and tell me what you think about it. And I was just listening to it. And, I mean, he got the congos going. He got African instruments, and it's just going. I'm like, maybe we could deal with that. And if we put a hip-hop beat to that, maybe I could do something with that. He brought me to the studio. I put a hip-hop beat behind what he was doing. And I was like, okay, but then he got that jazz melodic. It's just a mixture. So I was like, yo, check this out. I said, I hear jazz in this. I hear African music in this. And I'm going to throw some hip-hop in it. So we're going to call it Afro Jazz Hop. That's how it became Afro Jazz Hop, because of the jazz feel to it and the African feel to it. And then when I threw the drums on it, that was the hip-hop. So I sat right there and wrote it right there. And then we just recorded it. And it was hot.
It's hot.
It's a different kind of hot, though, for all you hip-hop heads like that. You know what I'm saying? Like how I was just spitting right now, you know. No, it's not that. This is Afro Jazz Hop. This is something new, buddy. And he has a market for that. There's a market for that, you know, the melodic crowd. You know, I could see a smoky jazz club with this type of crap. But, you know, and the drum beat, it's just it's crazy, man. I'm feeling it. You know what I'm saying? All we need is a video, and then it's going to be popping.
What are the bars like on that?
Well, the bars are a little different than what I'm doing now, but, you know, it's me. You know what I'm saying? I'm going to always bring fire to the table, bro. Always.
I feel that.
Yep.
So, Javon, you want to go ahead and...
Javon, yo.
Oh, my bad. Government, my bad, yo.
Trouble kid on the air.
See, we making a lot of mistakes tonight, aren't we?
Hey, man, you don't call Superman Clark Kent.
Clark Kent. Save her, Clark.
Man. Come on, man. But look, y'all hearing it first on WRTC Hartford. You're listening to Africa at Work.
Yeah.
With the Trinity chapter of Temple of Hip Hop.
African pizzazz is when the hip hop drums meets the crash and the African percussion sounds sweet with the scratch. Lyrically, I'm a beast, I'm from the streets of the past. All the rappers pay attention while I'm teaching the class. Liquid T got a lot of rare beats in the stash, producing nothing but the hits out in the streets is a smash. I'm speaking the real and you speaking the trash. I'm a hip hop head with CDs in the dash. Drive 100 miles an hour up the streets and I'm fast. Plus, the music got me hyper in my streets if I crash. It's for the love of hip hop because I believe in the craft. That's why I'm doing it for the culture without receiving the cash.
DJ Trouble Kid.
Happy Jazz Hop is
doing something to me, cause I love the hip-hop drums over the deuce and goonie with the jazz piano chords. Music be flowing through me, so melodic to my soul and my spirit, that's how it do me. Put the rhythm in the hips of the women shaking their booty. Tease on the production, your homie doing his duty. Another hip-hop track, only this one's a doozy. It's the fusion of the culture, the African music move me. The creativity and the passion, and that's the beauty. Originality, and that's coming from yours truly. I'm hip-hop soundtrack, but there's no movie. Only me and Liquid T, we the stars, no George Clooney. I spit it, rapid fire with no Uzi. Make the girls go wild, don't believe me, then ask your cutie. Jazz mixed with a little African pizzazz, African pizzazz, African pizzazz, African pizzazz.
Afrojazz hop.
Yep.
Krush Money.
Yep.
So I heard some cuts in there, man.
Oh, actually, those cuts are Cut Master Bistro. We resurrected some of his scratching from some of the old tracks that we did before.
That is
that's him.
That's dope. That's dope. Because yeah. I'm like, hey, hold on, man. Right, you said Tim DJ, but I'm like, hold on.
Oh, brother. No, not hold that on, kind of DJ.
I'm like, hold that's on, Stro. Tim? Tim, hey, WRTC needs you, big fella. But yeah, man, what else can we expect from this project, man?
What, this project here?
Yeah.
Well, you can get it on Spotify and iTunes and all of the rest. You know what I'm saying? It's already out there.
Okay, man. Can we, any possible performances coming up, man?
Well, I'm pretty sure. You know, Tim, we'll probably be at the next college event, ripping it down. You know how we do.
Next college event.
Yeah, we be at some average. We be at some colleges. We be doing some colleges. I be like doing some, a lot of seminar talking and stuff like that. But that was before we dropped this track. I'm pretty sure we're gonna be doing a little something too. You know.
He said college events.
Oh yeah, we be doing some college events.
He ain't mentioned the college yet right now, man.
Well, y'all got up. Got administration. Put us down, man.
All right. So look, check this out, man. We got the temple. We got the annual.
The 13th annual.
Temple of Hip Hop International Festival.
I would be honored.
But before that, we got the mini festival. You know what I'm saying? And this is more so, Hartford based.
Okay.
You know what I mean? And I think
just to give our fans a little bit of a taste of what the fest can bring.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I think we got to get you out there.
I'm willing to do it all. I mean, anything you guys do, because I'm from here, I represent here, you know what I'm saying? So, you know, hey, let's get it.
Yeah.
I think it's highly important, man, for the younger cats, man, to know that they got the support from the legends, man. The legends.
Definitely the legends.
Krush Money.
Pow.
Krush Money, man. So do you have any shout outs, man, that you wanna give at the moment?
Yeah, man. Tania Janelle, I see you watching, so I gotta give you your shouts, you know what I'm saying? You watching it. I mean, well, not watching, but you're listening. You dig? You're tuning in.
Much love.
Girl, my kids, my moms, my whole city, you know what I'm saying? I represent the city. You know what I'm saying? Cutmaster Beast Droid Originator, his wife, his daughter, his moms, his brother, Smooth. You know, he working with me on his album, you know. One Roof Productions, you know what I'm saying? That's where I work at, you know what I'm saying, with the video production and stuff. If you need a hot video, you want to come and see us at One Roof, because that's what we do. All CGI and, you know what I'm saying, special effects, you know what I'm saying? None of the boo-ah. It's always the hoo-ah.
You had to go bust on us for a minute.
Yeah.
But before you get on out of here, man, I got to ask you.
Mm-hmm.
What younger artists are you listening to at the moment? What's bumping in your headphones, man? What's bumping in the whip? You know what I mean? What you got going on, man? What you listening to these days?
What I'm listening to these days, yeah. Who am I listening to? I listen to the Migos a little bit.
I listen to them a lot.
I know. I mean, that's why I listen to them, because I know y'all listening to them. I want to see what y'all seeing them.
Yeah.
And they ain't put on a dress yet, so I can check them out. I can listen to them. Once they put on some skirts.
What they wore at the BET Awards.
I was not feeling it.
I don't know what that was.
It looked like Soul Train 1972 to me.
Shout out to the Migos and DJ Academics.
Definitely.
I'm going to just call them Academics. So I don't see why he's a DJ. And we ain't going to talk about that, though, man. So you got the Migos. Okay, All right, hold on. I got to ask you this, man, because you come from a different... You come from, like, the foundation of hip-hop.
Definitely.
So what project inspired you to become an MC?
Hip-hop, baby, baby, hip-hop, but you don't stop the rock.
Really?
Really.
Oh, wow. Tell the people the name of that track for those who don't know.
Rapper's Delight.
Rapper's
that was the
Delight.
Name of it. Sugar Hill Gang.
That was not the first rap song, by the way.
No, it wasn't.
It was the first recorded rap
song. I had that one, too. That was Fatback. Don't you hesitate.
For those that don't know, that wasn't the first.
That wasn't the first. Fatback was first. And then a couple of months later, there was Sugar Hill Gang. But Fatback was first with King Tim III. And I was rocking to that, too. I knew all of the words.
That's heat, brother. I just want to say, man, on behalf of the Trinity chapter of Temple of Hip Hop, brother, thank you for coming out, man.
Oh, no doubt.
And
thanks
blessing
for having
the
me,
mic,
boy.
Man. We really appreciate it.
Definitely.
Continue to do great things, man. We're gonna be here along the way. Man, we hope to have you back.
Oh, you got me. Anytime, you know man. You got my personal number. Hit me up. I'll catch the fast track like tonight.
Ain't no pepping that step, man.
You heard me?
All right, Chester. You're listening to Africa at Work, hosted by the Trinity Chapter of Temple of Hip Hop.
Yes, sir.
And DJ Triple Kids, you about to go back on the one and twos.
Yes, man. I'm about to get back on the ones and twos, man. I'm actually about to dive into a Hartford MC's song, man. This kid goes by the name of Prince Eli. This track is called K-Swiss off his upcoming project, Book of Eli. You guys can catch him at the Temple of Hip Hop Mini Festival taking place November 17th at The Mill, which is 79 Vernon Street, from 7 to 9 p.m.
Yo, that title sounds real interesting.
K-Swiss?
Eli, yeah.
Yeah, man, you got to check the... You might like it. You might like it. I hope you like it. I like it.
Oh, I like it if it's dope. If you like it, yeah. I think I'll like it.
All right, bet, man. So let's dive into this thing. K-Swiss, Prince Eli, y'all listening to Africa at Work. With the Trinity chapter of Temple of Hip Hop, DJ Trouble Kid, Cody David. Let's get to it, man.